My dear Ellie, I have to find her. A shred of hope. All what a man needs to keep moving before he loses his sanity and his will. Walking along the shore reminded me of the walks I used to have with my wife. They speak of a fisherman who was lost in a stranded sea. He never came back. Now I know where he lies. What misfortunes could have drove him here? I have offered my right arm and spoke the correct words in his absence. Only pain accompanies me towards my demise. I was forced to leave the lighthouse. There's something wrong in all of us. The slumbering god can save us now. What god is he talking about? As we sent our feet in the sand the last time, she asked me to tell her one of my stories about the wild sea. I could hear each of her breaths getting shorter and shorter. And by the time I finished my story, pneumonia took her life.
And let him die in here. What made them forsake their settled ways?
voice. Get out of my head.
This monolith is the key of the silent. Break it free.
As a young boy, I remember my father talking about this island. He described it in a way that would scare the listener. He spoke of black butterflies, corpse candles, and broken cups. This island feels like it's maintained, untouched by time. The wind and the waves pause for a minute to rest. A calm before the storm. Despite his fear about the island, he would often come here fishing some very colorful fish. I remember finding myself quite disturbed as I watched him stuff his mouth with their raw meat. Feels like it was always a part of me, as if it has taken a hold of me and won't let go. Another foot in the sand, but this time sink deeper beneath the shore. My daughter's toy gave me some sort of happiness. Yet I can't take my mind off the idea she's been taken by one of those creatures. Solitude and peace is what a soul seeks after being free. Did they die in vain? It appears they were murdered. What a horrible way to find solitude.
slumbering god. I have sealed him from within. Break him free.